Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss few very important functions of Excel which will help you to analyze your data. So it is useful in each and every domain. For example, you are a college or university faculties and you want to manage your attendance and marks, or you are working in the examination department where you need to prepare a report on the student's result. Or maybe if you are working in some areas of analytics, for example, you have a data of some salesmen here instead of students, and you want to compare how much sale they are making for different categories of products. So you have different categories of product here, and you want to see that which salesman is making highest sale or second highest sale in what particular category, and different other things based on those sales figures you want to analyze. Or if you want to analyze any data which is related to any sports, for example, we have different cricketers, and here we have cricketers, and here we have their scores or runs scored by them in different matches, and you want to see that which cricketer has scored highest run in a particular match, or which match, or in a particular match, who has scored the highest run or second highest run, and all these sort of things. If you want to do, you can use these important functions in Excel, which we are going to discuss today. And you see that all these things which I have created in this sheet are automated. Actually, I have also used conditional formatting. You see here, and if I just change here, for example, I see highest marks in math is 97, and it's written here Amit Kumar has scored highest marks. And I have even made a statement like this, Amit Kumar scored 97 in math. Now if I just change it, I make the marks of Ayush Sirohi. As of now it's 27, but if I make it 98, what happens? See, the names are automatically changed that Ayush Sirohi has scored 98 in math. So it's not that I have manually computed. You can just do one time work to create a sheet like this, and automatically when your scores or your marks gets changed, all these things will get changed accordingly. So enough of talk, let's see it in action, how we do it today. So I have made a copy of this sheet here, and these are the marks. Basically, if you see in the previous sheet, these marks I have taken from these separate sheets, like math marks are here, physics marks are here. So this also we have used some function to take these marks. As of now I have these marks here, and these are different columns which we are going to compute. So let me do it here. Yeah, so now we got a blank sheet with the marks of different students. So you see here we have row number 3 up to row number 12, and their marks in 4 different subjects. Now few tips and tricks which comes handy if you have 5 subjects and you want to insert one more column. So you can just click here, and Control plus is the shortcut, and you can add marks in that subject here also, right? So as of now, let me go back to this format. Now we all know that how we find sum, we have this autosum function. So if we double click here, it will automatically find the sum of these 4 marks. Maybe in the older version, if it fails to automatically select the range B3 to E3, you can see the formula here, then you may probably want to write the range here. And sometimes what happens, if it is not the range which you want to select, so it is always a good practice that you recheck what all cells or what range it is taking inside the sum function, and if you want, you can correct it also. So that's the total marks, and I believe you all are familiar with these basic functions, but if you find it little fast, or if you want me to explain a particular thing, you can write it in the comment box. So I'll make separate videos on those basic things. Now let me find out the percentages here. So if I want to find the percentage marks for this, I need total. So I need to write here total also. So let's assume these marks are out of 100. So math marks out of 100, students has received this like this. And if I drag it here, all these subjects are total 100. So let me finish completing this column of totals. So you know that you can always copy paste the same formula to these cells, or you can drag, or you can just double click and it will be copied up to the entire table, because I have the table up to here, so it's copying here also. But let me delete it. Now percentage I want to find out, that for Akash Garg, how much percentage he has scored. So that's very simple. You might not be knowing it already, that we put the total marks scored by the student in the numerator, divide it by the total marks 400, and we put a percent sign here, so that we get, okay, the students receive 72. And let me drag it. Oh, you see there is some error, because what happens is, in my first cell I have written this formula F3 divided by F13, and when I drag this formula here, basically it is automatically changing the cell reference. So it is using F4. F4 means this marks, and divided by F14. This is F14, and F14 is empty cell, so when we divide by 0 we get an error. So we did a mistake here. We need to lock the cell. Whenever we want to do this kind of calculation, we need to lock this F13 cell. And to lock this cell, it's very easy. You just take your cursor there and use F4. And in a separate video I have discussed relative referencing. We have different types. You keep pressing F4 and you see the dollar sign's position is changing, but as of now I want to lock it completely. Okay. And now if we drag, we get percentage marks here. And let me also complete this column so that we don't get this error. Here, for example, we want to compute average marks. I have written average marks here, so I want to compute average marks in each subject. So average marks in mathematics, different students have scored minimum 27, maximum 97. I want to see average marks. So we have a formula for that. In Excel, whenever you start typing, you get suggestions here. You can use these suggestions, or you can go to a function here, or you can go to formulas here and search for the relevant function if you are new to Excel. So average of these marks, we need to select a range. So these are the range of mathematics marks, and then so we got average marks in math is this. And if we drag it here, then it will automatically change the cell reference as usual, and it will give us the average marks in different subjects. So you see here in physics, this is C3 to C12, average marks in these, right? So we got this. And here also we can drag it, average marks in total. Now pass and fail, if we want to make which students have passed the exam, which student have failed the exam, and the criteria is total, this percentage should be greater than or equal to 40 to pass the exam, then what we can do is, always we start a formula with equal to sign, and we need to check whether this thing is greater than or equal to 40. If we just check this, what happens is it will give us answer in true false. Let's see, it's true, means this student has passed the exam, and almost everyone have passed the exam except this, which Ayush Sirohi, who has failed the exam, right? But if you don't want to see these true false, instead we want to see pass and fail, exact terms for pass and fail. Then instead of using greater than equal to, we need to use if condition. So let me use the if condition here. If you see here, we have these options, so we are using this if. And you can even use tab from your keyboard to get the formula like this. So your logical test was the same, that the percentage mark should be greater than or equal to 40. Now if this condition is true, what do you want to type there? You want to type there passed the exam, or passed simply, or whatever you want to type. So I am going to type pass. And you see the second argument asked value if false, means if the percentage marks is not greater than equal to 40, it is less than 40, then what you want to type? So we want to type fail, and if we hit enter, okay, yeah, so we got the error, because we have seen that we have passed some text or a string inside a function. Whenever we need to provide a string inside a function, we need to put it inside double quotes so that Excel understand it's a text. Otherwise, Excel is thinking, what is this pass? Excel only understand numbers, and for a string data type, we need to put it inside double quotes. Some programming languages accept single quotations also, but in Excel, it needs to be specifically double quotes. Yeah, it works. So now it tells that Akash Garg passed overall, and we can drag it to all the cells, and we see that almost all the students passed except this one, Ayush Sirohi, and we see total percentage of marks at 39 for the student, so it has failed. If we change this marks manually just to see whether the formula works correctly, now it is also passed. It's not suggested, but I am showing you that whenever the data gets updated or you change the data, your columns automatically gets updated. And now in this column, I want to compute some eligibility criteria. For example, maybe for competition exam or some campus placement, if the company is having some criteria for the students to appear for that exam or interview, then you can find out which students are eligible for that or not. If we just have one condition that overall marks should be greater than 60% or so, then we can use a if condition as we have just seen here. But sometimes we have multiple conditions which we need to check for one particular eligibility criteria. So we will see how we can do that. For that, we need to obviously use if, because it's a conditional statement. Inside that, we can use and or. These kind of logical statement to put multiple conditions. So let's see one example. Here I am making a condition that the student is eligible for some exam if his marks are greater than 60 in math, physics and chemistry and greater than 14 English. That's the criteria. Whatever criteria you have, you can put it here. So I have made a criteria. In math, it should be greater than 60. Physics, chemistry, it should be greater than 60. In English, it should be greater than 40. All these four conditions, if all these four conditions are satisfied, then only he is eligible, otherwise not eligible, right? So I need to write all these four conditions. I'm using AND, which is a logical statement here. And because we want all these four conditions to be satisfied together, so AND is a perfect statement there. This is math marks greater than, I need to put here 60. That's my condition. And comma, I need to write second condition. This part is highlighted because I have, whenever you put a comma, you will see the next part of, next argument of that function is highlighted. Now my second condition is marks in physics. It should also be greater than 60. And whenever we write any cell reference here, that particular cell is highlighted so that we can quickly catch if we are selecting the right cell or not. Now marks in chemistry should be greater than again 60, and I'm adding one more condition, marks in English should be greater than 40. That's okay to have 40 marks in English, right? So when I close this bracket, you see this AND function is completed, and I'm back to my if function here. You always should refer the functions which it is suggesting here. As of now, you are in the logical test condition. If you have a complicated condition using few more combinations of AND and or NOT or something, you can put it there. As of now, that's enough for us. Let's put a comma. And as soon as I put a comma, I see this argument of the function is highlighted. What to do if this condition is true? So we want Excel to type eligible. If the condition is true, it will it should type eligible, right? And if the condition is not true, it should type not eligible, because these are strings. Again, make sure of the double quotes, eligible and not eligible. And let me hit enter after closing the bracket. I made a typo spelling mistake, I think. That's okay, but the purpose is just to tell you how it works. We see that first student have not scored greater than 60 in math, and he has scored good marks in other subjects, greater than 60, greater than 60, greater than 40. Only math marks are problematic. Let me just cross check. If I just make mark 65 here instead of 53, we see now he becomes eligible, right? So the formula works fine. So we can drag the formula for all the students.
You might have noticed one more thing here that whenever we are doing some typing, some of the cells are highlighted.
We have calculated using two functions.
For that, I have used conditional formatting.
Similarly, we can use great function to
highlight some of the cells.
For example, same question we want to solve, but this time we want to see another example.
If you want me to discuss conditional formatting in detail, I will prepare a separate video for that.
Student eligible with the same condition. So let me write this thing, if, because it's a conditional statement. Here I'm going to write or condition instead of and, right? And or means the student will fail if his marks are less than 16 any of these subjects and less than 14 English, right? So I'm going to write this kind of a condition here just to show you a different example. So math marks, if it is less than 60, comma, physics marks, if it is less than 60 again, comma, chemistry marks, less than 60. I hope you are getting it, that we are checking if either this or this or this or this, any one of the condition is true, then what to do, right? And English marks, less than 40, right? So if any of this condition is true, means the student should not be eligible, then what we need to do is we need to write not eligible here as the condition when this is going to be true. So let me write not eligible here, and obviously I'll be writing eligible here, and I hope I have completed the brackets. Yeah, and we see the same result. So we just have done it twice to show you the examples of using if with and using if with or, but the same criteria we have used, so we are getting similar results. And it's again a way of cross-checking that we are doing it right. Sometimes we do some typo selecting the cells or something.
You might have noticed one more thing here, that whenever we are doing some typing, some of the cells are highlighted. So for that, I have used conditional formatting here. It's always great to highlight some of the cells to grab our attention to a particular rule or a particular observation. If you want me to discuss conditional formatting in detail, I will prepare a separate video for that.
Now, here we need to find above average marks in a particular subject. You want to find the salesperson who have scored, who has made above average sale in a particular category. You want to see the player who has scored above average run in a particular match. Then how you can find out? So we have average marks here. We just need to find out above average who has scored, or above this student has scored above average or not. Who has scored, that we will do later, right? So first of all, we are seeing for first student Akashkar. So his marks in math is this B3, and we need to check if it is greater than the average marks in math. So average marks in math is this. And we can hit enter and we will get true false, right? We are just checking greater than or less than, right? So we will get true false. Now if we will drag it, right? So this is above average marks in math. If you drag this formula, you see that who has scored above average marks in math and who has not scored. Wow. Only except Akash Garg, all the students have scored above average marks in math. That's awesome. No, that's not awesome. We see that Ayush Sirohi has scored 27, and here we are getting this thing. I hope you got the error. Again, we had not locked the cell. So you, whenever you want to drag the formula to the column, right, for all the rows, you are dragging it here, then you need to make sure that you have locked that cells row number, right? So I need to log this by using F4 again, right? And by locking 14, I am making sure that it is always stuck at the 14 cell. Why I am not locking B, that you will see soon, because I would like to see the same for physics or other subjects. So let me drag it. Intentionally I am doing these things first with error and then correcting it, so that you get to know that when you do these kind of calculation, and if you are a beginner, you need to pay special attention to these details. Otherwise
you have learned all these formulas and a minor mistake may give you false results, right? So now we see that who has scored above average marks, like Aditi Malhotra, we see 75 is above average, 69.5 greater. For Akash, it is true. For Akshit Kapoor, it should be false. So we see here, it is false here, right? So we can always cross-check. If you are a beginner, I would suggest you to cross-check always. Now, above average marks in physics, if you want to do, then you can simply drag this formula here. And see, the formula here was doing V3 greater than V14. Now, if you drag, it is doing C3 greater than C14. So, C3 is marks in physics and average marks here. So, it is checking that thing. So, that can be done if you want to see if the student have done above average marks in a particular subject or not. And always you can drag. If you want to do the same thing for chemistry also and for English also, you can insert two more columns. And you can simply drag this thing and you can simply drag this thing. Right, so this is above average marks in chemistry and this is above average marks in English. Anyways, these were all basic stuffs, and next what we want to see is above average marks in all subjects. So that I'm leaving for you as an exercise, that you can use what we have learned till now and find out. Now, highest marks in any subject. So this function is very simple and you might already be using this function max, which is giving us maximum. So maximum of these, right? As of now, we are just doing highest marks in any subject. We will also see highest marks who has scored in any subject, right? These kind of things which are more useful. So if we do that, we see that highest marks in any subject is 89 here for the student Akash Garg, right? And he has scored highest in English. If you want to see in which subject he has scored, we will see in a short while the formula for that. First of all, I would also like to tell you one more function which works as the same. So instead of max, we can always also use another function, large, to see the highest marks or the largest number in that particular range. And what's the advantage? You see, that it takes two arguments, array and k. K means highest or second highest or whatever you want to put. So let me first select the range as we have done in max. If I just write 1, it gives the highest marks. I am doing it for second student. You see highest marks is here 79, right? So it is giving me 79. But if I want to see second highest marks in any subject, means Aditya Malhotra has scored highest marks in physics. Means for that particular student, Aditya Malhotra, his highest marks were in physics. But second highest in which subject he has scored, if we want to see, then we just need to change the argument to 2. Let me just do it. And if you make it 2, we see 75. So Aditya Malhotra has scored highest marks in physics, then in math. And similarly, then in English, there is a tie. But actually, yeah. So math and English, both he has scored 75, then he will get chemistry if I change it to 3. So let me change it to 3. Again, it is 75 because there was a tie. And let me change it to 4. Now it is 68, right? So, as of now, let me copy the highest marks in any subject. Yep. Now, if you want, sometimes autofill doesn't work because this column is empty. So, you might need to drag it there, right? Now, you want to see highest marks in which subject? Means you want to see Akash Garg has scored highest marks in which subject. So, this thing you can use. Two functions here you would need to use, index and match function. How we can use that, that I will explain here. I need to fill up these rows also, so I will explain this thing here, and this column P I would leave for you to fill up, right, as an exercise after you finish watching this video. So let's complete first of all these row also. And here we can see that highest marks I have made for this particular column. It means in mathematics, in the class who what's the highest marks. So again we can use the maths function as we have just discussed, and let me just select mathematics marks. So in maths you can see 97 is the highest marks, and it's highlighted also. And similarly we can use the large function which we have just discussed, and again we can select the range. Here we need to give one more argument, 1. So you see 97 again. So it gives the same result when the argument is 1, but it has an advantage that if we want to change the argument we see the second highest marks in math. So in this column you can read quickly, it is 94. It's a small data set, so 94 is the second highest marks in math. So that's why it becomes useful at times to use maths function. Rest it's your choice which function you want to use if you just want to find out highest marks. So let me drag it for all the subjects and even the total. Now if you want to find out who has scored highest marks, it's very similar problem to this column, highest marks in which subject. So we just don't want to see the marks 97, we want to see who has scored, right? Then we need to use a combination of two functions. In Excel there are always multiple ways to do the same thing, and we are just discussing one approach here. You might be using another approach. In some cases one works best, in another cases another approach works best. Here we are understanding the use case of match and index function. There are other similar functions also, VLOOKUP and XMATCH, the new function. So if you want we can discuss those later on. First of all I am filling up some entries here, right? So who has scored highest marks, I'm just showing you one example of using match function. It's a very useful function. So how it works is we select match. You see it takes three arguments. One is the lookup value, means which value you want to look up in that column, right? So I want to look up this value 97. Now because I have already calculated highest marks, I can just select this cell. But usually we don't do that much work. So instead of selecting this cell B16 here, we can apply here the formula maths or large, whatever you want, maths of these, right? So even if you do that, I need to close this bracket. This will again take the value 97. So it's your choice if you want to use max, if you want to use 97. In this sheet, because we have already calculated this here, we can use this cell to make the things easy if you are beginner, right? Now after match or after using this cell, you want to tell lookup array. You see the second argument is lookup array. Means in which array, in which column or in which row you want to look up for this value. You want to find this value. So obviously we want to find this value in this array, right? Match marks array. So again we need to select the same range. Now comma. Now it asks for match type. In match type we have three different options, and if you want to match exactly you need to write 0, right? You see three options here. 0 is for exact match, and we have 1 for largest value, that is less than or equal to lookup value, and similarly we have -1 for something else. Now as of now we just want to match it exactly, so we use 0 and we just close the bracket and hit enter. So here when we just use match function, it tells us 6. 6 means index number 6. 6th student has scored highest marks. So let me just count. This is my first student, although the row number is 3, but this is my first student. So first student, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. Sixth student has scored 97. So whenever you will use match function, it will give you index of that lookup value in that array, right? Now let me just quickly drag it and see here it is 5. You can see this was sixth student, this is fifth student. 9 for chemistry, so sixth student, 7, 8, 9th student. And similarly this is 8th student. So this function is working fine that we have checked, right? Now we don't want these indices, we want the name of the student who has scored these marks, right? So what you can do is you can use index function. And how you use index function, let me write here. So we need to use index function. In index, we have two different functions. So we would be using first. We are not discussing all the functions and all the arguments in detail. Here we are just seeing that for this particular example, how we can use. So we need to use the first function. First of all, we need to give array. Array means we need to give, because we want to find out name of the student, right? So we need to give the array of names of the student, means this array, right? So this is the index which we want to match. This is for example sixth student, so we want to find out sixth student from this array, right? And after that you can just write this six, the result of the match function which you have already done, and that's it. It has one more argument here, is column number, and you see this argument is written in brackets. If you look it carefully, it's written in brackets. And whenever you see a square bracket, means that argument is optional. Basically, in index function, either you need to give row number or you need to give column number. So one of the argument remains optional. That's why it's in bracket. So we don't need to give the column number. Hit enter and you see Amit Kumar here. So it has given the highest marks 97 and name of the student Amit Kumar. Right? Let me just cross check it. If I change the marks of some of the student, for example, I make it 99 here. Now, as per the change, Akash Ahlawat should get the highest marks in math. Let's see if the changes are visible. Now we see highest marks 99 here, and the name of the student is Akash Ahlawat. So we don't need to change these things manually. Whenever the marks will get updated, the sheet will automatically get updated, right? And let me see what happens if there is a tie. For example, Amit Kumar has scored 97, and let me make this also 97. Let's see what happens. Again, the highest marks is 97, but the name of student is Amit Kumar. It's not changing. Why it is not changing? If you have noticed that name of these students are in alphabetical order. So whenever there is a tie, it will prefer to write the name which is in alphabetical order, with coming first, right? Which name is coming first. For example, if for cross-checking, instead of Ayush Sahdev, now I change the marks of Akash Garg. So Akash Garg, I am changing it to 97 now. You see, when I change the marks, all these rows also gets changed, because we have used formulas. So now Akash Garg is eligible, and a few other things might have changed. So Akash Garg 97, Amit Kumar 97, and you see now who has scored highest marks? It's Akash Garg. Basically both have scored, but it is giving us in alphabetical order who has done, right? There might be ways to get both the names, but let me quickly see this thing. If we drag it for all the subjects, so again we are getting marks. I need to lock the cells, because whenever we are changing the references here, references A3 to A12, these are the name of students, and these are going to remain same for all subjects whenever we are checking, right? So we need to lock these cells with using F4, otherwise it will move those cells also. And let's drag it. So now we got to know that in maths, the topper is Amit Kumar. In physics, topper is Akshit Parekh, Ayush Sahdev and Anurag Bali. So we got these names, right? If you are a beginner, you can do it in two steps as we have done. First, you use this match function here, and then you use match index function here to get the index. Let me write index of student. Using here we just have used match function, and here we have used index and match in combination. So for a beginner it's okay if you use it like this. Otherwise, inside index function you can write this argument of match function, then also it will work, right? One more thing, if you just want to write some strings and you want to concatenate in Excel, it's very easy how you do that. For example, I just want to write Akash Garg and Aditya Malhotra are friends. I just want to type this. How we do this? Those who have done some programming, they know that there are ways to concatenate the string to type, right? In Excel also we can do that. So let me select A3, which is Akash Garg. Now I want to write something. So I need to use this ampersand from my keyboard, right? Akashgar, end. Now, whatever text I will write here, it will come in continuation. I'm selecting again the cell, which is Aditya Malhotra. But see that this is the name of the student and this is the name of student which we are concatenating. We are not giving any space. So if I do that, I will not get any space in between. And if you want to give a space, that can be also done using the ampersand again. I just want to type, these are friends. So our friends, space, our friends. This I am typing from my keyboard, and again this double quotes. And if I just type this, you see, this is the text we are getting here. Akash Garg, Aditya Malhotra are friends. If I want to write in between and also, if I want to write a space also, again we can use so many ampersands and we can make the complete sentence. So here I can write end, and basically to give a space I need to type from my keyboard the space bar. Now it looks better that Akash Garg and Aditya Malhotra are friends. So this is a way to type strings in Excel automatically. Now we will use this logic here to type a text here that Amit Kumar has scored 97 in math, right? So let's see how we do that. This is the name of the student who has a score. So I'm not typing Amit Kumar, because whenever the data will change, my string should automatically change, right? So name of the student, and I want to type space has scored space, and I need to type marks also, how much he has scored, and I don't want to type it manually. I always want my formula to pick up the marks. So this is B17 cell I am using, again ampersand, and in which subject. So whenever I need to type a string, I need to put it in double quotes. So in, and which subject. For that I can type math, but I don't want to do it manually, so that I can generalize it for all the subjects. So where is math written? It's written here in this cell B2, right? And if I hit enter, we see the complete text. Amit Kumar has scored 97 in math. Isn't it cool? Akshit Parikh has scored 99 in physics, Sudev has scored 89 in chemistry, and Rag Bali has scored 95 in English. So if we have done this kind of things, automatically, even if the data gets changes, we get new rows, new columns, everything, we get the sheet updated every time with all the text. And definitely we can use conditional formatting to grab our attention to a particular thing. I hope you find this useful, and I would leave this for you to explore how you find out highest marks in which subject. Hint, you need to use match and index function. You can use it in two step if you are a beginner, otherwise you can use it directly. So in this sheet, what all things we have covered till now. So from the beginning, we have done so many things in one video. Let me quickly revise. We have used sum function, auto sum function. We have used greater than equal to or less than equal to kind of true false condition. We have used if condition, and inside that we have also used and, or, if or also. So we have used if or these conditions. When we have multiple conditions, we have used these things. We have also used the formula for average, we have used formula for maximum value, we have used formula for largest or second largest value, these all things. Apart from that, we have used match and index, and we have also seen how we write text. So basically string concatenation. These things we have seen. You see these formulas are here. If you want to look for particularly string formula, these are here. You can explore further, right? That's enough for today. If you want me to explain a particular thing again, or if you want me to discuss a few more Excel functions which you find useful, you can write it in the comment box. And if you use these kind of functions in your particular area, so you can write in which domain you are working and where you find these formulas useful. And all these formulas which we have done in Excel, we can do these kind of analysis obviously in R and Python. Those are more advanced programming languages and quite easy to learn. There it's very easy to do all these kind of things with the very few lines of code. Thank you for watching.